Hi, ADHD parents. My name is Brielle. I created this ADHD parent support group. You might recognize me from the tips and tricks video. I hope you've watched it. If you haven't, it's pinned to the top of the group. Today, I want to talk about the explosive child. In that video I mentioned, I referenced talk time. That's something I started doing with my son when he was 3 years old. It was divine intervention. It was something that I didn't realize he needed. I thought kids just kind of were built with it. And when I say talk time, I'm not just talking about spending one-on-one time with your child. I'm talking about you are asking the right questions to try to help your child become emotionally aware, to understand their emotions, to be self-aware, to be able to regulate themselves. And it sounds easy to do, and it's true. 15 minutes a day. It's easy to do, but it's easy not to do. And we've been doing it with my son, who's now 10, since he was 3. We've needed to do it less and less as he's gotten older and since we've been very consistent with it. But it works. We don't have the meltdowns, the tantrums, the anger, the aggression. And an explosive child can explode in more than one way. My second son, he's like my little softy. He's my like emotional like ball of tears. Love him dearly, but things that you'd think don't matter, he has a complete meltdown and he'll just cry and he doesn't want to talk about things. And so we find other ways to help him with that, but it's still an explosive response. It doesn't have to be anger to be an explosive response, but I wanted to just kind of give you a heads up that you have to read The Explosive Child. That's something that every parent who doesn't have a typical, normal child who can, you know, regulate their emotions, if they don't have executive, you know, functioning skills, which ADHD children do not, you cannot parent them like they do. You cannot parent your children how you were parented. Most cases, usually, because these children are different. If they can behave well, they will. So if you're having any sort of issue, you need to figure out why. Why are they having behavioral issues at school? Why are you having fights over homework? Why are you having fights about dinner? Why are they freaking out over the color of their cup? There's a reason why. And it's usually not about what they're actually freaking out or melting down or exploding about. And that's what you need to understand. Your job is to help them understand. So you need to read The Explosive Child because it shows you like how to have those conversations. It talks about, I can't remember if it's, they call it drilling or digging, where you're asking questions. And if your child says like, I don't know, then you ask more questions. And it's not grilling your child. You are simply trying to understand them. You are trying to understand them and then you both together come up with solutions to help you overcome the issue, the struggle. And it has to happen. And I'm gonna share with you, I'll give you two examples of kind of the outcome of doing this. So about 2 years ago, one of our cats suddenly passed away. We were just shocked. And he had a brother. We got them as kittens. And we just were totally floored. And my son, who is, you know, my explosive child, he, oppositional defiance disorder, ADHD, you know, high IQ, so just intense kid. He's awesome, but he's an intense kid. Anyway, those cats were like therapy for him. If he was having issues, we could just put a cat on his lap and he would totally calm down. He would sometimes suck on their paws because he had some oral sensory issues, but anyway. Justin passed away and 6 months go by. We're still doing our talk time. Austin starts having just like, he's just angry. He's angry about something and I'm asking questions, trying to figure it out. And I said, you know what, let's go take a bath in my big bathtub. I've got like a huge, like 2-person jetted tub. So he puts on his swimsuit and, we're in there like swimming. We're just sitting in there with the jets on and bubbles. And we just start talking like, you know, what is going on? Can you think of it, if there's something in your mind that keeps kind of repeating that is making you feel angry? And it comes out. He starts to get upset. He cries a little. And that's mostly where the anger comes from, is they're trying to stop themselves from feeling emotion. And all the emotions kind of go through a processor and come out as anger or tears or behavior issues, whatever your kid processes it. And it turns out he thought that I didn't try hard enough to save Justin. I think he heard me talking on the phone with someone about how they were gonna, like, they had kind of like three treatment plans, and we actually chose to put him down after we tried a bunch of things, like $500 later. we weren't able to save him. There were no guarantees he would have survived even after like $3,000 and a week of, I just didn't want him to suffer because his organs were shutting down. Anyway, Austin felt like we didn't save him and that, you know, we just let him die. And we, you know, and so I explained everything to him, what our options were, why I thought that, you know, what I had said to him, his last moments, just, he's a kid that needs to know details. And he had been carrying that with him for 6 months. That had just been inside, and he kept thinking about it over and over and over. It's like it's on replay, and it was manifesting as other issues. And we had talked to him about the cat dying. It's not like I like put him down and then was like, all right, well, you're good, right? You're good? You're not sad? No, like we had talked in depth about the cat. We buried him. We talked about him. We shared memories of him. We talked, you know, we were checking on him a lot about like how he was feeling with it. But I think he was afraid that I'd get upset with how he was feeling, that I'd get angry or defensive. And that's why honesty has always been, we talk about things in our home. And as long as we're honest with each other, they've learned, my kids have learned that they're better off being honest. So that's one outcome. Now, fast forward to, he's 10. He was supposed to go to bed and he came out of his room and my husband and I are sitting there. And you know how you're like done? It's like 9 o'clock rolls around and it's like, I'm already not wearing a bra at this point. I'm like done. I don't want to be an emotional compass anymore. I don't want anyone to touch me. I just want to like work on like some sort of like craft or something and watch like Netflix. And he comes out and you know, you're kind of thinking like, ugh. But luckily I held it together and I was like, what's going on? Or what's up? And he said, I need to talk to you about something because I know I'm not going to be able to sleep. And you could tell it was something he was getting upset about. And so it was something with a friend. They were having some sort of disagreement. And so we talked about like what his options were, what he could do, what he thought he wanted to do. And we also talked about like why his friend might be acting the way he is. And I told him, I was like, Austin, did you see what just happened? You didn't get angry. You didn't destroy anything. You didn't take it out on me. You didn't take it out on your sibling. I was like, you were self-aware. You knew something was going on. You knew you needed to work through it. And that is huge. And it's taken us 7 years. 7 years of being consistent. He also told us during talk time, he said, I kind of feel angry. I think I might need more medicine. I think I need to up my medicine. And so I said, well, okay, I'll talk to your pediatrician. Well, I made an appointment and sure enough, he went in, they weighed him and stuff. And she said, yeah, he should be getting more. And she was super impressed that he was able to be self-aware like that. And pretty much if you start to think in your mind, I've tried everything. Sorry, but no, you haven't. And most of the time, the answer is going to be something small, seemingly insignificant that you have to do consistently. Yeah, I know it's hard. I know, like, sometimes I'm like, oh, like, I would just want to have, like, the normalcy. But there is no normal. And these are the skills that these children need to learn to be functioning adults, to have good interpersonal relationships. These are things that we've, like, role-played, conflict resolution. We've, you know, role-played the, being kind to people and like what's socially acceptable. We have had to teach our children everything and we've learned how they process things. My one son, Bennett, his favorite book is Penguin Problems. It's hilarious. Don't forget to read the inside jacket part. It's so funny. And that's helped him tremendously. That's like his go-to. My other son, Austin, you know, the one that is 10 now, he loves art. He drew a picture. I should have like brought it over here, but he draws things. Sometimes when we were doing our talk time, if he just, sometimes they don't want to get upset. They don't want to cry. They don't know how to express themselves because they don't even know what they're feeling. I would hand him his sketchbook and he would draw it out because then he doesn't have to say it because then he feels like he gets more upset and he's embarrassed to cry. I mean, aren't we all? So you just have to find what works for you, but you just have to keep trying. You can't try something for like 2 weeks and then give up. This has been years of consistency. And now he's self-aware and he even drew, this was a few months ago, he saw me post something in this group about, it was an iceberg and it had all these emotions on it. And then underneath the iceberg, it had what the actual emotion is your child is feeling. And he was like, I feel like that. And so he actually like went off to his own thing. He came back and he showed me, he's like, this is how I feel. And it was this machine. There was like a conveyor belt and then there was a machine and then there was a conveyor belt. And it was like all these emotions on one side of the conveyor belt. And then he wrote processor on the little machine. And on the end, all it said on the conveyor belt was anger. And he's like, this is my processor makes everything just feel like anger. And I'm like, yes. Like victory, like you're gonna eventually start having those mom wins. And I still like, he like, you know, he sometimes gets mad because the thermostat isn't at the temperature that he wants. And he'll say like, do you even know how to turn on a thermostat? And say, I'm sorry, can you please try to speak to me in a calm voice so that we can have this discussion? And he knows that I'm always willing to talk about it and that I'm not trying to control him. I give him back as much control as I possibly can, which is complete opposite of how I was raised. It's you're asked, if you're asked to do something, you do what you're told. So you have to read that book. Hopefully this inspires you and doesn't make you feel like you're like failing, because you're not. You're in this group. As long as you're a lifelong learner and you're trying to understand your child and you just keep trying, you're not gonna fail. If you keep trying, you're not gonna fail. I also apologize for the lighting. The sun keeps coming in and then going away. So I either look yellow or I look albino. So yeah, it is what it is. I'm not professional. What you see is what you get with me. So if you have any questions, even though I'm going to end the video, just leave them in the comments and I'll reach out to as many people as I possibly can. But as I'm approving posts and I'm seeing people's posts, I'm like, talk time and explosive child, talk time and explosive child. A lot of it boils down to that. Yes, he's on medication. Yes, we've done a bunch of other things with like his sensory and, but honest to goodness, it mostly boils down to the talk time and the explosive child. And read that book so that you can learn exactly what it looks like, what the conversation is supposed to look like. So I hope you found this helpful, beneficial, and thanks for just being part of the group. And I hope you have a great day.